Said we'd camped out on the plains at the head of the Cimarron. When along we'd come a stranger to stop Moggy some. He looked so very foolish, we began to look around. We thought he was a greenhorn that just escaped from town. We asked if he'd had his breakfast, he hadn't had a steer. So we opened up the chuck box and made him take a shear. He took a cup of coffee, some biscuits and some beans, and then began to talk about the foreign kings and queens. About the Spanish wars and fightings on the seas, with guns as big as steers and ramrod big as trees. About old Paul Jones, a mean son of a gun, was greatest cuss the Lord he had ever pulled a gun. When in the finished eating and he put his plate away, he rolled a cigarette and asked the time of day. He talked about the weather, the election, and such things, but didn't seem to know how much the working's on the rings. Such an educated fella, his thought just came in herds. He astonished all them cowboys with them jaw-breaking words. He just kept on a-talking till he made the boys all sick, and they began to look around to play some kind of a trick. Well, he said he'd lost his job up on the Santa Fe, a-going across the plains to meet the 7 B's. He didn't say how come and it was trouble with the boss, but he would like to borrow a fat, nice saddle horse. Well, it tickled all the boys to death, they laughed way down their sleeves. Well, you can have a saddle horse as fat and nice as you please. So Shorty grabbed the lid and he wrote those either done, and he turned him to the stranger while we waited for the fun. Well, old Dunny was an outlaw that grown so very wild. He could paw the white right from the moon for every jump a mile, but stood right still as if he didn't know, until he was all saddled and all ready for the go. When the stranger hit the saddle, Lord old Dunny quit the earth, a-headed right straight upward for all that he was worth, a-pitching and a-squealing and a-having wall-eyed fits, with his hind feet perpendicular and his frontings in the bits. Well, you could see the tops of mountains under Dunny ever jump, but the stranger set upon him just like a camel's hump. The stranger set upon him and he curled his black mustache, just like a summer border waiting for his hash. Lord, he thumped him in the shoulders and he spurred him when he whirled. He showed his flunky punches that he's a wolf of this world. And when he once more dismounted there again upon the ground, we knew he was a thoroughbred and not a gent from town. The boss who'd been standing round and watching all the show walked right up to the stranger, he said, you needn't go. If you can handle a lead like you rode Ozeba done, well, you're the man I've looked for ever since the year of one. Now he could handle the rope, boys, and didn't do it slow. And when the cow stampeded, he was always on the go. There's one thing and a sure thing I've learned since I've been born. Every educated feller ain't a plum green.